Profit and loss reporting. In this video, I'm going to show you how to generate a profit and loss report by currency from the sales of all of your currencies. So let's get started. Up on your toolbar, you'll need to go across to reports. Once here, we go down to the second line, P&L by currency. So profit and loss by currency, select right here. And in the next field, we can set parameters for the report generating. So for the from date, we actually have to leave that as inception date. So we leave that as 00. So that will show that that is our inception date. Unless you actually know the date that you did actually start the business, you can enter that date in right here. But if you're unsure and there are numbers in there already, quick shortcut on your keyboard, just hit X and it will take you back to the all zeros, which is the inception date. Then we can tab down into the next field, the to field. So this is where you can set the date you want to put that to. So we can either go over to the right and we can click on the calendar button and actually select the date from a calendar. Or we can use the buttons down below, the shortcut buttons. So we can put in today's date. We can either do beginning of month, end of month, same for the year. And then we can also plus or minus months or years or days in order to put in the parameters that you want to set for this report. So let's keep it as today's date. I'm just going to go down to click on OK. Now when you go to print these reports, you want to make sure that the orientation is set to landscape. And then once that's done, I'm going to click on OK. And instead of printing right now, I just want to show you an example of what that looks like. So as I'm on a Mac, I have the capability of opening this in a PDF just so we can preview this. If you're on a PC, unfortunately you can't do that, you'll need to print it. So I'm just going to select the preview right now so I can show you what that looks like. So here's the report. So you've got the dates, you've got inception date to today's date. We've got all of our currencies. And then by column header you can read we've got total bought, sold, any leftover, the cost of the purchase. And then all the way to the far right we've got our profit for that currency. Now in our home currency, which is the US dollars, you don't typically make a profit, but you can see that we do actually have $203 in this profit for currency column. That is because we actually charge fees for those transactions. So you can see that that's in the fees received section column. We also have outlined below here that we've actually got a loss in a couple of currencies, so you can see why that is. You can take a look over on the right-hand side here. We've still got quite a lot of currency left over, so we have the potential still to make profit in those areas as we've bought quite a lot of Canadian and Euros. And then down at the bottom, you see we've got our gross profit, total fees, and our net profit from sales. So let's say that you actually want to run this report not based on inception all the way to today's date, but you want to put in, you want to figure it out, let's say for the last month, how much you have actually done in profit and loss. So I'm just going to show you how to do that right now. We're going to go back into CurrencyXchanger, go to the top toolbar again and select reports. We're going to do the exact same thing, P&L by currency. We need to keep it as inception date, as I explained previously. But when we put in the date here, let's just say that it was actually the month of January that we want to run this report for. So first of all, we'll run a report all the way from inception to the end of January, so January 31st. And then we can actually do the same process, make sure it's on landscape. And then we can just open as a PDF or you print the report. And that will give you our profit and loss based on inception all the way up to the 31st of January. Then what you need to do is go back into CurrencyXchanger again, back to your reports on your toolbar, down to P&L by currency once more. And this time it's inception date and then 2 would be the beginning of the month. So you want to go beginning of the month of January because we're doing it for January to January 31st. So we've got January 1st right here selected in the 2. And then we can generate the report once again, exactly the same way, and then using those numbers you can then minus this report from the first report, allowing you to then see your profit and loss for the whole month of just January. So once again, in this video I've taken you through how to generate a report for profit and loss by currency from sales of all of your currencies.